Espinedo committed to submit to the chair instead of an executive session the names that I have asked. I think the chair can remember that. Yes. With the commitment that it will not be devolved except if those personalities, no, including the one who ordered to delete as based on the affidavit. May I manifest, Mr. Chair, that it should be reflected. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Dagoog. Please take note of the manifestation of Congressman Dagoog, COMSEC. So there is a motion to dispense with the reading as amended by Congressman Dagoog and consider having it approved. Is there any
second?
Julie seconded. Hearing no objection, the motion is carried. So magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Please allow the chair to deliver his opening remarks for today's committee hearing. Esteemed colleagues, co-chairs and vice chair, guests and resource persons, ladies and gentlemen, magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Today, as we continue our investigation, we shall center on the pressing issue of POGO. In our past hearings, we have established the following. First, POGOs are establishments created by Chinese nationals on the pretext of providing overseas gambling operations catering mostly to Chinese in the mainland. We, however, proved that these operations are actually not legalized gambling as this is not allowed in China. The POGOs here were engaged in money laundering, human trafficking, drug trafficking, and gruesome crimes like murder, kidnapping, and torture. Second, we discovered that the drug money was used to buy influence, corrupt the government system to obtain fake Filipino identities in order to acquire real properties, real estate, and other properties where these POGOs are built. The illegal operations of the POGOs are then used to cover and clean the drug money or money from illicit activities. Lahat po ito ay nangyari sapagkat nakipagsabwatan sa kanila ang mga kawani ng gobyerno. Kapalit ang salapi, pumayag at hinayaan ng mga kawani at matataas na opisyal ng gobyerno na sila ay magamit bilang mga protektor, kinatawan at mistulang nag-aabogado pa para sa mga POGO na ito. Di alintana ang kapahamakang idudulot sa bayan, itong mga traidor na ito ay hinayaang yumabong at lumaki ang impluensya at kapangyarihan ng mga sindikatong ito basta lamang mapuno ang mga bulsa ng kayamanang kapalit ng dangal ng bayan. Ngayon ay magpapatuloy tayo sa pagkilala sa kanila at sisiguraduhing mananagot sila sa bayan. In the light of these challenges, we are here not only to expose the wrongdoings of the past, but also to craft the necessary legislative solutions that will prevent these problems from recurring. Thus, the following proposed legislations are now being studied. Number one, Philippine adaptation of the Racketeer Influence and Corrupt Organizations Act, a United States federal law that provides for extended criminal penalties and a civil cause of action for acts performed as part of an ongoing criminal organization. Number two, review or amendment to the Special Investors Resident Visa Program pursuant to Book 5 of Executive Order Number 226, Series of 1987, as amended. Number three, amendment to the Philippine Retirement Authority's power to approve retirement visa to foreigners. Number four, amendment to the Anti-Dummy Law or Commonwealth Act Number 108, as amended. And number five, amendment or review of the implementation of Republic Act Number 11983 or the new Philippine Passport Act. Number six, the revision of Presidential Decree Number 651 on late registration of birth to stop the proliferation of simulated birth certificates. As we get more valuable information, QuadCom has been getting discrediting remarks, proof that the targets are hurting. Let me take this opportunity, therefore, to remind everyone that the power to conduct investigations in aid of legislation is a fundamental function of Congress enshrined in Article 6, Section 21 of our Constitution. This is not a mere privilege, but a duty to the Filipino people. Congress is empowered to investigate, to compel testimony, and to demand documents when it is necessary to fulfill our legislative mandate. These inquiries are designed to shed light on matters of public interest, to recommend policy reforms, and ultimately to legislate for the welfare of the nation. It is clear from both precedent and the Constitution that this committee operates within the bounds of law. Contempt orders are not acts of overreach, but rather tools to ensure compliance with the legal and procedural obligations imposed on all citizens. Let me state unequivocally, this committee will not be deterred or undermined by baseless accusations of overreach or abuse of power. We have the authority, the responsibility, and the will to pursue this investigation to its rightful conclusion, regardless of any obstacle. As we move forward, I urge everyone involved, the witnesses, the resource persons, and public officials alike, to cooperate fully with this committee. The people of this country deserve nothing less than the truth. And let me assure you that this committee will not be swayed by threats or distractions. Our mission is to uncover the facts and to ensure that those responsible for any wrongdoing are held accountable. Together, we will continue this fight until we finally get to the bottom of these issues. Magandang umaga ho ulit sa ating mga kasama sa Kongreso at ang ating mga resource persons ngayong umaga.
Okay.
The next is to deliver his opening remarks is the Chair of the Committee on Public Order and Safety, Congressman Dan Fernandez. You are recognized.
Thank you. Maraming po salamat. Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Today, as we embark on another day of hearing, discussing certain issues relating on illegal POGOs that was eventually stopped by the government and no less than the President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos, still we heard certain areas in our country that continually operating their illegal operations. As we are continuing to deliberate in this Quad Committee, these illegal operators operating their clandestine operations without haste. Iba talaga ang kinang ng pera ng salapi sa mata ng ating mga nasa gobyerno at nagpapatupad ng mga batas. Nakakalungkot isipin na after the declaration of the President on the stoppage of this illegal POGO, meron pa rin na nahuli sa Cebu, sa Kawit, Cavite, at just recently sa Cagayan, which turned out na non-operation na or maybe, just be notified of the implement of impending raid of the PNP. Indeed, yung galamay ng sindikato dito sa operasyon ng POGO ay di tumitigil. Bakit kaya? Napakahaba naman ata ng kanilang PC. Napakadami naman nilang salapi that even with the pronouncement of the President on the stoppage of these POGOs, still, there are certain places where POGOs still exist. Hukayin po natin ang ugat ng lahat ng ito at saan sila kumukuha ng lakas ng loob upang ipagpatuloy ang mga illegal na operasyong ito. Recently, as I've heard in the discussion in the Senate, there were allegations of former Chief PNP who received payola for POGOs. Is this true? Totoo ba ito? Is this the reason why operations in conducting on the stoppage of the illegal POGOs in the whole country are not being implemented? Or they are just stories that need no attention for discussion? Bakit masyado ata madaming pera at bilyon-bilyon ang operasyon ng POGO? From construction of big facilities, buying of lands of certain Chinese corporations, and the financial transaction through bank exchanges of big amount of money. Kung iisipin mo, di lang talaga online gambling eh. Saka hindi lang mga scams ang involved dito, but the money being laundered in this operation are so blatant that need no deep explanation for an ordinary person to understand. pera to ng droga. Pera to na nanggaling sa Chinese operators na gustong linisin ang kanilang pera dito sa kanilang operasyon sa Pogo. Conducting these hearings led by the four committees have not stopped these people in their illegal operations. Marami pa rin ang patuloy na nag-ooperate ng kanilang illegal na operasyon hanggang meron sa ating kapulisan at mga nanunungkulan sa ating pamahalaan at lokal na pamahalaan ang patuloy na tumatanggap sa illegal na Pogo. Sila na dapat na magpatupad ng pagpapatigil ng Pogo must be held responsible as well. Marami pa po tayong dapat gawin. Marami pa po tayong dapat na malaman. Mahirap makipaglaban sa kinang ng salapi na bumubulag sa ilan nating kababayan upang ipagpatuloy pa rin ang operasyon ng Pogo. Sa ating mga kababayan, tulungan niyo po kami. Kung meron po kayong nalalaman sa patuloy na pag-ooperate ng illegal na Pogo sa inyong mga lugar, buligligin po natin o bulabugin po natin ang ating mga nanunungkulan sa ating mga bayan at mga hepe ng kapulisan na kumikilos, na kumilos sa kanilang mga nasasakupan. And without compliance, please, please, report to the Quadcom and we will act accordingly. Sama-sama po tayo sa pagsupo ng kasamaan. Sama-sama po tayo sa bagong malinis na Pilipinas. Salamat po.
Thank you, Congressman Dan Fernandez. The next to deliver his opening remarks is Congressman Bienvenido Abante Jr., the Chairman of the Committee on Human Rights. You are recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. My fellow co-chairs and colleagues in the Quadcom, our resource persons, and at the same time, witnesses and guests. Ladies and gentlemen, magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat. Nakita niyo naman kung gaano ka-passionate kami dito sa hearing na ito. Si Congressman Dan Fernandez po ay maaaring na maging preacher later on, mga kaibigan. But I would like to mention and quote to you what a bad person said at one time. Ang sabi niya, and I quote, "The world suffers a lot, not because the virus." The sixth Quad Committee hearing, this representation finds it necessary to reiterate our primary purpose, to uncover the truth so that we may produce legislation that will prevent the evils we have unearthed in these proceedings. We are here not only to shed light on past wrongdoings, but also to ensure that our laws will be fortified against future exploitation. There's an old saying that I quote, "The devil is in the details," end of quote. This phrase serves as a powerful reminder for us today. If we are to draft meaningful and effective laws, it is incumbent upon us to gather as many details as possible. The devil, in this context, takes many forms. It exploits the loopholes in our laws, uses gambling as a front for illegal activities, and uses a war on illegal drugs to justify the killing of thousands of innocents. Our duty here, as legislators and duty bearers, is to gather every fine detail so that we can craft legislation that will not only close these loopholes, but will also ensure that these evils can never take root again. In Ecclesiastes 12:14, it is written, and I quote, "For God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil," end of quote. This passage should remind everyone that no wrongdoing can remain hidden forever. It is our role in this inquiry to bring the secrets to light so that justice can be served and righteousness upheld. We are tasked with shining light on every dark corner, leaving no detail unexamined. It is our solemn obligation to obtain the information necessary to deliver justice for the victims of POGO, illegal drugs, and extrajudicial killings, and to shield future generations from these evils. However, there are those who seek to obstruct and hamper our efforts. Let us be clear, their actions are not only detrimental to this inquiry, but also the pursuit of justice and the rule of law. We must condemn those who have, having been involved and having profited from these illicit activities, now seek to hide and cover up their wrongdoings. Their attempts to evade accountability must not and should not be tolerated. They can run, hide, and use semantics to camouflage their cowardice. Ultimately, they will be exposed for who they really are: enablers, accomplices, criminals, and deceivers. Kaya sa mga tumutulong sa amin with their testimonies, their candor, and their courage, maraming salamat po. You are doing your countrymen a valuable service, and more significantly, you are doing good deeds before God. In the face of these challenges, our resolve must remain firm. We conduct these hearings in aid of legislation because we know that without strong, enforceable laws, the evils we have uncovered will continue to thrive. I'd like to remind everyone that we are a government of laws and not a government of men. We are here to ensure that no devil, in whatever guise it may appear, will be able to use gambling as a front for illegal activities, to endanger families with the spread of illegal drugs, or to carry out acts that claim innocent lives. In the end, the goodness that comes from the Lord shall prevail. Let me tell those devils who chose to attack us with demonic trolls. I would like to mention what a high official said. Ang sabi po niya, "You can skin us alive, burn us in the stakes, and throw our ashes with the wind, but we will remain unbowed." End of quote. And resolute in finishing this investigation until we come to the ultimate conclusion for the benefit of our people and for the sake of our country. Maraming maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat.
Thank you, Congressman Abante. The next to deliver his opening remarks is Congressman Paduano, the Chair of the Committee on Public Accounts and Good Governance.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We have already consumed almost 1 hour of our hearing. So, and we have still a lot of admin matters to be discussed. And with that, Mr. Chairman, once again, I'll just submit my opening remarks to the COMSEC for purposes of records. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Paduano. The next to deliver his opening remarks is our Senior Deputy Speaker, Congressman Dong Aurelio Dong Gonzalez. You are recognized.
Salamat, Mr. Chairman. May payabak po kay katamungan. Magandang umaga sa aking mga mahal na kasama sa ating mga panauhin at sa lahat ng nanonood sa live stream. Bilang mga lingkod bayan, ginagawa po namin ang ating tungkulin na nakasahad sa ating saligang batas at mga patakaran ng mababang kapulungan. Nagsasagawa po tayo ng mga pagsisiyasat para makatulong sa paggawa ng mga batas at para malaman ang katotohanan na may layuning maging tapat at responsable sa ating tungkulin. Ang mababang kapulungan ay bumuo ng quadruple committee, iQuadcom, as a principal proponent of this na binubuo ng apat na komite: Dangerous Drugs, Public Order and Safety, Human Rights and Public Accounts. Ang layunin nito ay alamin at lutasin ang mga komplikadong issue tungkol sa paglaganap ng illegal na droga, mga illegal na gawain na konektado sa POGO, human trafficking, at mga kaso na extrajudicial killings o EJ case na kaugnay ng kampanya laban sa droga ng nakaraang administrasyon. Mahalagang tandaan ang mga pagsisiyasat na ito na ginagawa ng Kongreso ay may tatlong pangunahing layunin. Una, upang makakuha ng impormasyon para makagawa ng bagong batas. Ikalawa, upang masubaybayan ang mga ahensya ng gobyerno. At ikatlo, upang ipaliwanag sa publiko kung bakit kailangan ng bagong batas o amyenda. Ang pagsisiyasat na ito ay hindi para magpakitang gilas o mag-usig, kundi para makapagpasa ng mga bagong batas gaya ng pag-amyenda ng Republic Act No. 9165, Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs of 2002, pag-aayos sa Anti-Trafficking in Persons Act, pagpapalakas ng Witness Protection Program at pagtulad sa RICO Act ng Amerika na layong parusahan ang mga grupong kriminal. Sa inyong pangunawa, pagtitiwala, determinado kaming patatagin ang ating pamahalaan at ipatupad ang batas at demokrasya para sa ating lahat. Maraming salamat po. Good morning po sa ating lahat.
Thank you, Senior Deputy Speaker Gonzales. We shall now, before we proceed with the admin matters, may we direct the committee secretary to please acknowledge the members present in our committee hearing today, as well as acknowledge the resource persons we invited for today's committee hearing. Comsec.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, Your Honors. Today, we have with us the following